Good morning. I suddenly noticed and sing, good morning, good morning, good morning to you. But I thought I wouldn't because I'm tone deaf and I didn't want to hurt your eardrums, but there you go. Anyway, Verity came over to see me last night, which was amazing. We came and had, she came and had some dinner here. And I wore a lovely floaty dress, one of my floaty dresses that I've got ready for Malaysia to dinner. And then it got a bit chilly, so we had to go out for a walk. So I put another one of the dresses that Kim had given me, fortunately, which is very much me, and I'll probably wear it with leggings in the winter. But I didn't have any leggings with me, so I just wore it as it was with my bike boots. But I think it was quite a good look I was rocking there. Didn't realise, apparently, this is meant to be the most haunted place in Lincolnshire and the second most haunted place in the UK or England, I'm not sure. But yeah, that's probably why I'm connecting so much. I don't feel any other spirits here. Verity did. But I think, you know, she said it's because Andy's all encompassing me. His spirit is the major one right now, so that's good. I'm back in my bike jeans, actually quite excited, and sporting my lovely Dragonfly t-shirt that Eileen bought me. So thank you Eileen. Thinking of you today as I'm riding home. I'm going home today. I am going past the via the sports bike shop though at Boston. So I've ordered a little hoodie to try on. Also helmet, more importantly helmet, because I'm wearing a helmet that I dropped a big time over in, I can't even remember if it was Wales or Ireland. I think it might have been actually in Wales right at the start. So if I come off, it's just gonna split right open. So I really need to get a new helmet. But I also need to negotiate trying to take my old one back with me because I want to use them. I have them all hanging up, or I might use them as plant pots. That's the plan. I'll have quite a number if I keep dropping them, won't I? Oh. Last night, Verity and I came for a little walk out here. And we left our phones behind. So thought, yeah, well, we won't be able to take any photos because it's dark. And didn't think until we were out here. Could have used them for torches, but we negotiated in the dark and it was okay. This was a little bit lit up anyway. But she said it's very dangerous letting me and her near water in the dark. But the spirits kept us safe. And then we went through this dark alley over there and then come to a tree, which I think might be that one through there, which was amazing. I hadn't seen it before. So I'm going to go and walk the same thing and see it from the angle we saw it last night. That's what we walked down in the dark last night, but we made it. We negotiated and then we came round and this was the tree, which is just incredible. Oh, look at that, the sun shining through it. It is just such an amazing tree. Sorry, I'm just fascinated with trees. And then I was like, oh, they could tell so many stories, couldn't they? And I'm like, just sit with them, feel them, touch them, feel their energy and they can tell you stuff. That's what we did. We just stood by that tree for ages. Look at this. You'll probably get a better judge of the size of this tree now. Look, and we sat here. It's huge. Anyway, today I was in a bit of a rush this morning, thinking, you're in a rush because I've run out of my duloxetine, which is my antidepressant, anti-anxiety medication, which is also for my bladder and also for my pain, for my fibromyalgia. And I've been coming down off of it for the last couple of years. But I'm now thinking, well, perhaps it is the next stage because it's the lowest dose of 20 milligrams to go. Now, maybe from just doing it 36 hours over 24 and gradually wean myself off, but it needs to be when it's right. But things do feel right now. I do feel the mentally best that I've ever been. I've been on antidepressants since 1994. I think I've only had probably a couple of months off of them in all of that time. And I never, things changed for me as a teenager. I never felt normal, but just like things shifted with me. I didn't feel me. I felt like an imposter in my own body, really. And I didn't feel like I fitted in. So that's when I started to drink. And I had terrible, what used to be called PMT, premenstrual tension. I think it's now premenstrual syndrome, PMS. But I mean, awful, to the point that I'd get really paranoid. I hated it. I hated that time of month. I hated being in my body a lot of the time. And it's only in the last 3 years since I've completely gone through my menopause that I start to feel me again. But I have to remember that I've also come out of a toxic relationship. I've had many in my life, been back with the love of my life. I've got sober. I've don't have to go to work anymore because I was medically retired. I now live an unconventional life, which I absolutely love because it's conventional to me. It's what I wanted. So there's lots of changes that have happened. But I really do think hormones have a massive part to play for both men and women. But just sitting thinking about it this morning, I think a lot of it is that we resist. We resist how we feel. And if we can come back to that, just accepting that we feel shit. I don't know, because it's so long since I felt like that. But I just know at the time it was horrendous. But I really think we need to look more at hormones. So I look back at all of my career, you know, and the turn, you know, the changes of people in their teenage years, the changes of their people at the time of their life when they're, you know, time of their life. You know, what a weird phrase that, isn't it? Having your time of life is meant to be good, but the time of the life when we go through our change is horrendous. And it happens for men too. You know, men do have PMT. I know it's not premenstrual stuff, but the hormones shift and we shift. You know, there's been those things that they've done, haven't they, with like when a group of women live together, they all start menstruating at the same time and things. So we are kind of tuned in, and yeah, hormones. Hormones and gut health. I think that's the way to the future, and perhaps gut health will help us with our hormones. I don't know. Because they do lots of good stuff, but they can do some really, really shit stuff too. Anyway, I'm going to shut up yakking. I'm going to sit and hug this tree. How can I sit and hug it? I'll do a bit of both. I'll interchange, and then going to go and find Andy's dinosaur tree. This is a really strange, it just seems quite random to have this here. Obviously some sort of deity, because somebody's put a paganish crown on him, or her, or they. I don't know, is it like, it's not even like Sagittarius, is it? I don't know. But if any of you do, let me know, because there's absolutely nothing written here. So I don't know what it is. Just trying to get it with the sun being ethereal. Nearly fell over then. Nearly fell over again. Oh dear. When your neural pathways don't work properly, don't try and walk and hold a camera. I've been doing pretty well until now. So beautiful and peaceful here. This all started because he wanted me to come to the woods that we used to walk in and to come and sit under a tree and connect, and that I would have a eureka moment. Well, his tree is over there, or over there, in the corner there. And there was even a little tree stump for me to sit on, look. Been back here 4 days running now. I came here and I thought, what was the message? I sat here and I was drawn to this area and this tree, and I thought, what's the eureka message? And I came away, I booked a hotel night thinking that was the message. Slow down, Karina, stop running around seeing if it's nice to connect, but you need some time for you and to treat yourself. That's what I thought the message was. And then yesterday it got to the point of, no, what the message was all you have to do is just stop, close your eyes, and I'm there. Just feel me wherever you are, wherever you go. And I think, you know, Verity said, because it's a Verity, sometimes not there, I can't feel him. He said, no, they're always around. It's just that we're not always tuned in, connected. So that was my light bulb thing, is I just have to stop, close my eyes, just be. I'm going to go over to the tree now. And just feel him. That's it. Final walk around Petwood grounds done. For now, anyway, until I'm back next time. Just had a few tears, but yeah, just so many realisations. Been quite incredible. I know it's annoying when I move around, but I just want to show you the scenery. Like, yeah, it has been incredible. I just know that Andy's all around me now. And I think sort of we had to go through this journey together to connect even more. And I've just thanked him, because actually I think the purpose of him going first was just show me that I don't have to fear death anymore, to not be afraid to die. Obviously I'm not planning to die anytime soon, but I'm not afraid of it now, because I know he's going to be waiting for me. And I know why I'm in this life. I'm never going to be on my own. He's always, always, always going to be with me, which is incredible. I love it. Anyway, I've got to go and drag my dry bag down now. I'm gonna, it's so heavy, so I'm gonna bring that down, some separate bits down, stuff it all, put it on top of my box, because I came with a full box, top box of stuff that I had to give people, that I loaded off, that I've given away to people, given to people, and then I've collected stuff on the way, so it's now full of the people's books and stuff. So everything else is in my drive bag, so I'm gonna get that done and then head home. And apparently there's a Battle of Britain display at Thetford today, so hopefully I'll see the Lank and the Spitfire or the Hurricane flying overhead as I'm riding home. I will keep an eye out for it whilst keeping my eyes on the road, of course. Just stopped here at Kirton Village Hall because I thought, oh, I've never seen this statue before, but I've just not been looking. It's William Dennis, 1841 to 1924. So I've just looked him up. He made his fortune at the turn of the last century from potato farming, and gave Kirton this town hall. So, yeah. Just been in Sports Bike Shop. If you haven't been before, it's a great place to come. You can order stuff online to try in store or just to get sent to your home. And when you get in, it's a bit like Argos. They've got screens in here as well. You can just like order it, and then they call your name out and it comes out. If you order online before you come, you just give them the reference number and they get your stuff and you try it all on. And it's good. I mean, I did stumble because the two helmets that I had to try on had different straps, and I was like, oh no, what am I gonna do? Had a little panic, because before obviously Andy would have gone, oh, come here, and he would have done it and shown me how to do it. So learning something new isn't always great with my neural pathways, but I managed to do it. And actually I could have just asked, because they're really, really lovely in here, they're really helpful. I've actually ended up with a child's or a junior helmet, so 50 to 51. I did try an adult's 50 to 51, but it was too hard, and then the 52 to 53 was too big. So I've got a kid's one, but he's going to send them to me. I've also bought an armoured hoodie, which I'm really happy with, but the only problem is the armoured hoodies don't have the back panels in, so I'm going to talk to my sewing lady and see if she can just sew a pocket in and I can swap my panels over, my back panel over, because I don't really want to be exposed without that panel. Anyway, they're posting them to me for free, so I haven't got to worry about taking me dry sack off or anything. Although looking at it, oh blimey, it's slipping. I need to sort it out before I carry on. The other day as well, when I was at Kim and Barry's, and you know, before I was like, oh, I don't know how this goes, you just strap it up in this big gap, and it only clicked in my sort of brain yesterday. Barry said, well, you're not going to roll it over. Yeah, thank you, Barry. I didn't know to do that, and I didn't do it straight away because it didn't click. I get there in the end. I've stopped for a little break off my bike, get my helmet off for a bit here, and I'm here in Downham Market. It's been a nice ride actually since Boston. There's some lovely people there at the sports bike shop outside asking about the license requirements for Can-Am Ryker, which again is pre-1999. You can drive it on a car license, grandparents' rights. Post-1999, you need a full bike licence, I'm afraid, although there is some discrepancy between 1999 and 2013, as you would have heard me say many times before. But they were really helpful, and they helped me get my dry bag. They helped me roll it up properly. So I listened to Barry the other day about doing it up, but I still wasn't rolling it up properly. So they rolled it up properly, squished it all down. I'm like, I've actually learned how to use my dry bag properly today, and lifted it all on for me, because I asked them to, because it's a bit heavy right now. Anyway, I've stopped now at Downham Market. It was a lovely ride through from Wisbeach to here, along the river, really quite pretty. There was a little hotel there that I wish I'd stopped at, actually, called the Moorings, because it was quite quaint, but I'd gone past. So I'm here now. Nice little market going on today. Just bought a little sun hat for Arthur Bear. Hopefully the sun will still be shining by the time he gets back from his holidays in Spain. Sun is shining beautifully now. Looking forward to getting home and getting out on my decking and reading my book. But for now, I'm trying to find a nice coffee shop with some cafes and some pubs. But I'm gonna head down the hill and see if I can find a coffee shop. Well, that should do it. It's called The Seat Coffee House. And I've done it about 20 times because it's a very busy junction of people walking.
We're just spinning this round trying to find a handle. There isn't one.
But look at this, it's so cool. There's a little hole in the bottom,
and you turned it up then, tipped it up to show you a little hole in the bottom so it doesn't spill over. I love it. The coffee's great. I've just just crossed over the road and then seen this on the other side, which actually I did see on the way down. But I've just seen a lady with a walking stick, which has just kind of reminded me that I still need to get one. I've really been struggling. I tend to forget when I'm back in town or can't find one. So I'm hoping I've got a foldable one in here for my bike. It's like a TARDIS in here and I've only just come in. Bumblebee draft excluders. I've got to remember, I've got my bike. I can't take anything back with me. They've even got, look, a stair lift. Well, I need it right now, but I do need a walking stick. Oh, wow. I love all these, but again, I have to remember I live in a caravan. I've got stuff everywhere, but look at this. 10 rules for a lovely life. Laugh out loud, dream big, love always, be grateful. Worry less. Hello. Make memories. Wake up smiling. Stay positive. Cherish every day. And have fun. Well, I did have foldable walking sticks. They even had a ladybird one. Instead of bumblebee, I probably would have definitely got it. I didn't get one because they're $28.99. Now, actually, I've spent money on cheaper ones and they do tend to sort of buckle up and not work very well, so it's probably worth paying the extra for it when you're looking at the foldable walking sticks. But you know what I'm like, I'm not paying £29 to drop it off the back of my bike, leave it somewhere, break it, so I'll just try and get a cheapy one from somewhere, and at some point charity shop, that might be a good shout. Let's go hunt. Just been in the Sea Rider shop, no collapsible walking sticks, but I did meet some lovely ladies to chat to. And just as on the way out, I mean, I've got loads of scarves and I really don't need one in this sun, but it's bumblebee colours. And I have only got a bike so far and I probably only have a bike for winter, so there you go. Wow, this is a nice little find. I came off the beaten track because I was chasing my shadow. Look, I was going to try and get a picture of shadow and me on my bike, but I needed a quieter road. I've just come across this. I didn't know where I was going, but eventually I rerouted. So Oxborough Parish, 14th century Norfolk church with rare 16th century terracotta tombs. Wow. Great for members of Oxborough men. Ah, oh, look, who died for their country in the Great War. And there's, that's a really nice place as well. I don't know if that's part of Oxborough Hall or not. We used to love going to Oxborough Hall. If you've never been to Oxborough Hall, I think it's National Trust. Is that the brown sign? Yeah, it was the brown sign. I think they're all brown signs, aren't they? What a stupid thing to say. Oh, it's the one with like the oak type leaf. That one. It might be English Heritage. I get them confused. But that's really lovely. If you've never been and you're up this way in Norfolk, then go check out Oxborough Hall. It is beautiful and you get the real upstairs, downstairs experience. Oh wow. I'm gonna go inside and find out some more. The energy here is amazing, but they're actually in the process of restoration again because of people stealing the lead roof. They've had a flood and there's lots of water damage, but these are just even hear a bumblebee. Just imagine what these are going to look like when they're all restored to their full terracotta glory. That's really beautiful. It's almost as nice as Petwood, you know, it's feeling the stone. I was feeling the wood at Petwood. I've got my favourite area there. Well, the wood's in the wood, obviously the trees, but the wooden staircase at Petwood is my favourite place to sit. And here, just feeling the wood and touching the stone and seeing that terracotta is amazing. Sell little leaflets here with the history. 50p, you know. So I could have flicked through and told you more about it. But I bought it. I'm a good girl, you know. This side of the church is very small, but still beautiful, that wood. It's got a really nice feel in here, I think because it's small. Dare I say it's got a bit of a pagan-y feel. That's probably why I haven't burst into flames. It's just really lovely. This terracotta is just superb. I thought, why have they got some chairs that way and some the other way? It's obviously like a book club or the book corner. You can buy the books, but I mustn't even look because I'm on my bike and I'm full. My probably final little break at home now. Although these aren't woods that Andy and I walked in, well, I think we did cycling them many years ago. We did used to ride through them on the 1066, which is our most favourite road around this area to ride anyway. The road surface is great, the bends are great. I'm going to go down to Thetford through these woods. I didn't stop at Brown's at Mundford because I've not long had a coffee. I'm just going to continue down the road, head to home, and then head on to Diss. And the 1066 from Thetford to Diss is also lovely. There's people even camping over there, look. A bit of wild camping. I'm sure it's just for the day. But I'm stopped at Linford Stag in Thetford Forest. Let's have a little break. And then 35 miles and 51 minutes to home. I don't want to get up. It reminds me when Andy and I would be knackered in the afternoon. We just find a field somewhere and fall asleep. I haven't been to sleep. I've just been editing my video. And I forgot what I was going to say. Oh yes, that other building near the church was Oxborough Hall. I'm going to find some little pictures of me and Andy at Oxborough Hall and put those up. But now I've got to try and get up. To crawl to my bike. I'm now at Halston. I'm not going to get much sunbathing done or reading because I've dilly-dallied around as I always do. And I've got half an hour until my favourite Chinese open. There's loads of eating places in Halston. In fact, there's three Chinese's, but Can Moon is my favourite. And in fact, there was a time we were there nearly every blooming night because all Andy wanted and could eat was their chicken and sweet corn soup. That kept him going. That and cappuccinos, bless him. Anyway, like with any town, there's loads of history here. I have read about it, but I can't remember any of it, but there is a museum here. Look, there's a museum. I get to find where it is, but it's that way somewhere. And it's open on Wednesdays and Saturdays, so I will put it in my diary to come on Wednesday or Saturday and find out a little bit more about it. In fact, I'm going to go and do a tour of lots of the little areas around here and find out about their history, because when I came into, not Nelson, but it is Nelson country, which is Norfolk, I'm like, yeah, but why is it Nelson county or country, whatever it is that it says? Because I think he did sail from Cromer, but was he actually from around here? I don't know. I need to go and find that out. And as I got into Thetford, it said ancient capital of East Anglia. What's that about? Something else I need to know. So from now on, wherever I go, I'm going to go as a tourist, I think. So because we look at all these signs, don't we, and we just take them for granted. So I'm definitely going to look at it a bit more. Anyway, you can probably hear some music going on in the background. It's because I've got into Halston. There's all these flags everywhere. And it's the food festival that I've forgotten all about. I got so distracted with Petwood that I forgot that this was on. And perhaps I didn't put it in my diary, I can't remember. My ego's just jumped out of its hula hoop though. They've shut the road off at a point where it blocks you off from the disabled parking, so you can't park in the disabled parking. And there's no reason why they couldn't have just blocked it off a little bit further up, really. But there you go, out of my control. Hula hoop, hula hoop, hula hoop. Bye-bye. See you soon.
To my name, hopped a bus. here I came. I could be brave or just insane. We'll have to see.
But maybe in that sleepy town, I'll sit one day, the lights are down, I'll see my face and think of how he used to know me.
Behind these hills, I'm reaching for the heights and chasing all the in the canyons that'll never fade away. The ballads in the barrooms left by those who came before. They say we gotta want it more. So I bang on every door.
And even when the answer's no, when my money is running low, the dusty mic and neon glow are all I need.
And someday as I sing a song, a small town kid'll come along. That'll be the thing to